नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, आई वुड बी टॉकिंग अबाउट व्हील, टायर एंड ट्यूब फ्रॉम दिस लेक्चर ऑनवर्ड्स. दीज फॉर्म एन इम्पॉर्टेंट कंपोनेंट ऑफ ऑटोमोबाइल. एक्चुअली ऑल थ्री कंपोनेंट्स आर इंटीग्रेटेड टुगेदर एंड कैन बी टर्म्ड एज व्हील. दीज फोर इन नंबर सपोर्ट ऑटोमोबाइल ऑन रोड. Movement of an automobile is possible only when wheels rotate. We have seen while studying transmission system that output from engine is transmitted to wheel causing their rotation. In present time, tube may not form part of wheel as we have tubeless tires available. The wheels of an automobile should be strong enough to take load. When subjected to an impact, these should preferably buckle and not collapse. Light in weight. Light wheels follow road surface quite accurately. That minimizes wheel bounce. Capable of providing cushioning effect and flexible support. Tires, because of flexibility, provide this. Tires should maintain their shape to provide support. Balanced statically and dynamically to maintain stability of vehicle while moving on road. Easy to remove from axle and easy to mount back on axle. It is essential that anyone using vehicle should be able to replace wheel in case tire goes flat. As mentioned earlier, wheel, tire and tube are integrated as wheel, but we would be studying them as three different entities. I would be talking about wheel first. Wheel. It is considered as invention that has made huge contribution to human civilization. In automobiles, Benz, a German engineer, patented first wire wheel in 1885. It was fitted with hard rubber on it. André Michelin used first pneumatic tire in 1895. It failed initially. Later, in late 1940s, they found use in automobiles. Aluminium casting wheels were introduced in 1960. In 1974, alloy wheels came in use. Nowadays, cars have 22-inch wheel that were introduced in late 1990s. Earlier, size of wheel was limited to 15 inches. Earlier, automobiles used to have wire wheels. These had wire spokes. Nowadays, they find use only in two-wheelers such as motorcycles. Except few special purpose vehicles, disc wheels are being used in modern vehicles. Wheels for car smaller in size are generally cast. Wheels for heavy vehicles big in size are forged. With advancement in material science, alloys found more and more use in making wheels. Alloy wheels commonly used these days have a number of benefits. Aluminium alloys that were used to make wheels provided similar strength as steel and weighed less. Later, magnesium alloys were used that further decreased the weight of wheel without affecting their strength. In addition to this, magnesium alloys have better fatigue properties and good resilience. Therefore, resistance to vibrations and shocks improved. their poor resisting ability to corrosion is a drawback. A protective surface coating helps to overcome it. Aluminium alloys still find considerable use in making of wheels. Another benefit of using alloys is that these have better heat conduction properties. Therefore, dissipation of heat from wheel to ambient air is quick. That helps in continuous running of a vehicle for longer duration. As per manufacturing process adopted for wheels, these are cast wheel and forged wheel. Cast wheel. Casting of wheel is done in mold. Once it cools down, trimming of cast is done. Tiny air pockets, if formed, reduce the strength of wheel. Modern casting techniques have minimized formation of air pockets or other defects. This has improved their quality. Cast wheels can be given good finish and also cost less. Forged wheel. These are made of solid block of alloy. Blocks of alloy are heated. Then these are subjected to high pressure. This gives block shape of wheel. High amount of energy is generated within material due to high pressure. This energy provides additional strength to material. This improves the quality of forged wheel. Manufacturing process being costly enhances the price of wheel. Present cars almost invariably have disc wheels, as already mentioned. Even heavy vehicles have disc wheels. Tire and tube in some cases are to be mounted on wheel. Rim is the portion of wheel that accommodates tire and tube. To understand it, let us refer to diagram. The diagram presents section views with horizontal and vertical axis. These are three views representing three variants of disc wheel. First, let us try to know constructional details. Referring to diagram on left, wheel comprises of disc and rim. Disc has been shown in black, whereas rim has been shown in red. Rim forms outer portion of wheel. In disc, as can be seen, there is a hole in the center. Then we have holes for mounting. These are for mounting wheel on axle. In this view, two holes are visible, but there are six holes uniformly placed. Number of holes depend upon size of wheel. Next, there are holes for cooling as shown. As air can pass through these holes, heat dissipation from wheel becomes quick. It is essential as due to friction, wheel is heated up. Holes in disc tend to weaken it. To overcome this problem, holes are swaged. Swaging is turning their edge smoothly inward. This compensates loss of strength. Their number again may be six or more depending upon size of wheel. Middle portion of disc has wheel cover. Wheel cover just enhances looks. Rim shown in red, circular in shape, surrounds the disc. In this sectioned view, it can be seen on upper and lower side. Tire and tube are mounted on rim. Therefore, it is provided this particular shape so that these can be accommodated. Lowermost portion in rim is known as well. Then curves on two sides hold tire bead, therefore these are called tire bead seat. About tire bead we would be learning later when we study tire. Flanges on two sides help to retain tire on wheel. Rim is provided with a hole for valve stem as shown. Now let us know about three variants of disc wheels. Three variants are inset, zero set and outset disc wheels. Diagram on left represents inset disc wheel. It may be noticed that disc is towards right of vertical axis here. Inset is represented by I in diagram. Diagram in middle represents zero set variant of disc wheel. Disc here is at vertical axis as may be noticed. Diagram on right represents outset disc wheel. Here disc is towards left of vertical axis. Outset is represented by O in diagram. Few other parameters related with disc wheel are nominal width, nominal diameter, and flange height. These are shown in diagram on right. Nominal width is width of rim as shown. Nominal diameter is the diameter of wheel measured across tire bead seat as shown. Flange height is vertical distance between tire bead seat and outermost edge of flange as shown. Disc wheels are used in vehicles of all variants from light to heavy. Heavy vehicles have wheels of big size. Mounting of tire and tube may be difficult if these wheels are made in one piece. Therefore, we have another classification of wheels. Accordingly, these are one-piece disc wheel, two-piece disc wheel, and three-piece disc wheel. One-piece disc wheel. These are suitable for wheels of small size. Here, rim and disc part of wheel are in one piece. All cast wheels are one-piece disc wheels, though they may be forged also. Forged wheels have better strength. Referring to diagram that represents one-piece disc wheel, it may be noticed that it is similar to previous diagram. It has hole for valve stem in upper portion of rim. There are cooling hose for heat dissipation with swaging to prevent loss of strength. There are hose for mounting on inner side of disc to mount wheel on axle. Only difference being that rim and disc are single piece. As already mentioned, wheel may be cast or forged. Two-piece disc wheel. Disc and rim are separate parts here that make it two-piece disc wheel. Referring back to earlier diagram, three variants, namely inset, zero set, and outset disc wheels are two-piece wheels. Rim and disc that form two pieces are cast or forged separately. In diagram, these are shown welded together. It can be spot welding or seam welding. Alternatively, two parts may be riveted together. These represent small wheels. In case of big wheel, two pieces may be joined together with the help of nuts and bolts. Three-piece disc wheel. To ease the mounting and removal of tire and tube, three-piece disc wheels are used. These are meant for still bigger wheels. Discs in these wheels remain similar to what we have seen in previous cases. Rim is in two pieces that makes it three-piece disc wheel. These rims have flat base. Referring to diagram that represents sectioned views of different variants of rim. As rims shown have flat base, these are variants of flat base rims. On left upper side, two-piece flat base rim is shown. Flange on right side with hole for valve stem is fixed. Other flange on left side is detachable. Contoured edge of detachable flange fits in matching contoured edge of flat base. This is sectioned view. It should not be difficult to visualize that detachable flange is in the form of ring. After mounting tire and tube, this ring-shaped detachable flange is force mounted. Contours provided keep detachable flange in locked position and wheel in assembled position. Two other variants that are shown in diagram are three-piece flat base rim and four-piece flat base rim. In three-piece flat base rim on upper right side, it may be noticed that there is an additional piece in the form of lock ring. Detachable flange is locked in assembled position with the help of this ring. Yet another variant, four-piece flat base rim shown on lower side, has both flanges that are detachable. Detachable flange on right is force fit on flat base first. Next, detachable flange on left side is placed and locked with lock ring. Having rim in two, three or four pieces is helpful in mounting tire and tube on wheels of big size. Four-piece rims are used in special purpose vehicles where size of wheel is extraordinarily big. There is yet another form of three-piece wheel that has been developed recently. These are custom made and are designed to accommodate modifications done in suspension and brake size. Three pieces or parts are 1. Forged center, 2. Inner barrel, conventionally known as disc, and 3. Outer barrel, also known as lip and conventionally known as flange. Inner and outer barrels are made of aluminium. Three pieces are put together to produce a wheel for individual requirements. Outer barrel or lip may be stepped or double stepped. Inner barrel may have any kind of disc design or even spokes. These can be provided with colors of customer's choice. Their prices are immensely high. These are meant for rich customers who want an exclusive look for their automobile. Here, discussion for today concludes. Thanks for watching.